Knuckleheads are out today. Everyone is just, for some reason, everyone's going mad on the roads. So guys, the Corgi, I can't remember if I ever discussed on how much the car cost me. So the car ended up costing me $14,500 for the 2010 Mini JCW. I thought when I had bought it at the time it was a fair price, considering what else was on the market. You know, somewhere were up anywhere between the $20,000 to $18,000. And I did know when buying this car, you know, he obviously wanted a little bit more, and I got it at a cheap price because it needed a little bit of work done to it as well, such as the lower control arms. So $14,500 for the car, and here in Australia there is a tax as well too. A stamp duty when you buy the car is an extra tax. You know, they want to suck the money out of you when you buy something here in Australia. So that was around the $500. So all up, guys, the car ended up costing me $15,000, which, you know, it was one of those things that $500 couldn't be avoided. I thought it wasn't a bad price for a Mini JCW, and the K's as well too. So, you know, 15 grand, and then obviously that's when the other expenses started, which is normal when you buy a car. You know, things go wrong, and I wanted to share that with you today on how much money, besides 15 grand on the car, how much money I have spent after that. So after buying Corgi, you know, the car needed a major service. Going through the previous history from the previous owner, it was definitely in need of a major service. You know, everything from, you know, your four spark plugs, NGK spark plugs, your air filter, your oil filter, your cabin filter. It basically had a major service, guys. It needed to be done. Dropped it off to the Metro Automotives at Ray, and he looked after me. And that was a, you know, pretty service that needed to be done. Again, it couldn't be avoided. So that was $530 for the first, you know, a lot of expenses going out on Corgi. $530 for a service, which, you know, is unavoidable. Not long after, you know, having the service done to it and taking it to Ray's, he sort of, you know, had a look over it as well. I had it up on the hoist and realized that, you know, it was going to need some major suspension work done on the Mini. And that was when we did bring it back to Ray's and decided that the front suspension, the front shocks, the lower control arms, the link pins, the top mounts, basically had to be all re-changed. You know, it was a pretty big job to do. You know, it was another long day there as well at the Metro Automotives, and it was something that couldn't, you know. Look, I probably could have lived with it for a while. You know, it started to get to the point where it was quite noisy. So the subtotal for that was $1,759.54. You know, like I said, it was an expensive thing that needed to be done, but, you know, in the end, I thought, let's just get it done. So what else have I spent on Corgi? You know, I was trying to not be too pedantic, but I thought I wanted to put everything down there as possible, you know, for my own peace of mind, and also to share with you guys in owning and how much money I've spent. So I ended up also buying a bottle of sea foam as well too, just to give Corgi a bit of a cleanup. I don't know if you remember, if you did watch, we had a bit of a carbon issue with Corgi not long after buying it, and I thought, let's go down the cheaper option and put some sea foam in. From memory, that was $35, as well as a bottle of sea foam to see if it helped my situation with that misfiring. It's not long after that as well too, I ended up changing the coil packs on the Mini as well too, needed to be redone. Again, that process of elimination, trying to find out, you know, whether it is the carbon buildup, the worn-up blasting that it needed doing, the sea foam, and I guess these are things when you do buy a second-hand car, not knowing, you know, what is sort of going wrong with it, what's going to need changing. You sort of start to get worried of, you know, how much money is this thing going to cost me. Coil packs, they were $198. All right, so another expense, you know, it was something that didn't need to be done, but something that I wanted to do. And that was the cob gear knob that we ended up putting on Corgi. So it was $100 for the gear knob and the literal extension as well too. The whole thing in total came to $135, which I thought that wasn't too bad for a bit of a mod inside as well too. And, you know, again, making the car your own as well too, something a little bit different. The thing that we ended up doing on Corgi as well too was the worn-up blasting. You know, it was something, again, that couldn't be avoided. It needed to be done, and that was the worn-up procedure on the intake manifold. You know, this car had a massive, massive carbon buildup, and, you know, it was something, when I bought the car, that I didn't, you know, didn't pick up on, it didn't do. There was no misfiring, there was no stuttering when I bought the car, so it was something that happened, you know, a few months down the track, and, you know, I guess it was one of those things, a little bit of bad luck. So that ended up costing me $850 for that worn-up procedure. You know, it was a long day. We were at the Metro Automotives all day, and I thought that was a pretty fair price, considering, you know, there are other places out there that do that procedure, and I know that they can be up in the $1,000 bracket, and a little bit more as well too. So it's, you know, it's an expensive exercise, and I, you know, I'd hate to see what, you know, Mini would charge as well too in doing that worn-up blasting. After having the carbon build up, the worn-up blasting done on Corgi, you know, I ended up going through the receipts. I was getting quite worried about the fuel filter in the back, to see if it had been changed, you know, trying to eliminate, you know, any dramas with the car. You know, you want it to be as perfect as possible. Probably a little bit OCD, a little bit fussy. So that ended up costing me $110 to do the fuel filter. I ended up doing the oil and the oil filter as well too, or ended up buying all that. So that ended up coming to $205 to do the oil filter and the fuel filter as well too. So I ended up changing it because it was very, very dirty and it never had been changed. And I'm pretty sure from memory, that's something that needs to be changed at roughly at around 100,000 Ks or around the 80,000 K mark. Another expense as well too, to add to the list, was the Michelin Pilot Sport 4s. That was $850 for 4 new tyres. And again, guys, this was something that I couldn't avoid. The tyres that I had when I purchased the car weren't the best. They were starting to get on the, you know, on the sign of that, you know, it's time to get new tyres. They were starting to get dangerous. And again, also another expense that I couldn't avoid. So I ended up changing those. So there's a lot of expenses on this Mini JCW, isn't there? Remember the left-hand control arm on Corgi, unfortunately. You know, there was a bit of an issue there. Again, that noise came back. And, you know, that wasn't a massive expense. That only cost me $150. Some of the other parts from the lower control arm were covered under warranty. So it wasn't an expensive, you know, fix. All right, guys, so lucky last on the list, and I'm sure there's going to be plenty more down the track in the near future on Corgi, was the new battery that we ended up replacing not too long ago. And that sells a YASA battery, $240 from Battery World. All right, guys, so the subtotal in total cost after spending $15,000 on Corgi, expenses after, came to $4,900. I even wrote it down. I'm not a very good YouTuber, am I? $4,983.54. So we'll just say $5,000 mark. So $5,000, you know, it is a lot of money, guys. And, you know, if you weigh it up, for the car enthusiasts out there, your car lovers, I guess it's not really a lot of money. You know, sometimes I think maybe I should have spent a little bit more money on maybe a better JCW. Would I have had these problems on a second-hand one? Maybe one for $20,000 as opposed to $15,000. It is very hard to say, you know. If I would have bought a better one, would I have had the same issues? Who knows? It's just unfortunate. So $5,000, you know, like I said, it is a lot of money. You know, the only unfortunate thing I wish, you know, it was $5,000 going towards, you know, a tune, a cat-back exhaust system, an intercooler, you know, the fun stuff that you know, when you buy a car that you can throw money towards and, you know, have the fun stuff. So, yeah, it's put me a little bit behind as in, you know, wanting to do things like that to the car, as in modding it, setting it up how I, you know, prefer to have the car. But, you know, that's just, you know, such is the life, as they say, and it's just one of those unfortunate things. So, you know, in the sum of things, I guess $5,000 isn't too bad. Rightio, guys. As always, thanks for watching. Something a little bit different for you. You know, I wanted to be as honest and as transparent as possible on how much money I've spent on my car. And maybe something for you guys as well too, if anyone is thinking about buying a Mini, things to look for, things that, you know, you might have to outlay money like I have. But there we have it, $5,000. Like I said, I'll take it on the chin any day. But guys, we're going to wrap it up. As always, thanks for watching. If you haven't already, please hit the subscribe button. It does help out the channel and it pushes me, Mark, to create more content for you guys. And also give it a thumbs up if you haven't. And stay safe, and I will definitely catch you guys on the next one. See you guys. Bye-bye.